I'm the bandit from Myrtle Manor, and I hang with the straighthustling.com.
It's the trailer park, man.
I'm a dope nigga riding in a dope car. Got a dope bitch, no panties, no bra. I'm a dope boy, just made 100 large. I'm some motherfucking round, bitch, I'm about to catch a dope charge. Dope charge,
bitch, I'm about to catch a
dope charge. Dope charge,
bitch, I'm about to catch a
dope charge. Dope charge,
bitch, I'm about to catch
a. We're back, Straight Hustling Studios. We got a new guest today, Bandit from Welcome to Myrtle Manor. This is Dick Darin. I got Money Mike and Stu.
What's hey. Up, what's up, people?
Back from the NRA convention. What?
Yeah. NRA 2015 in Nashville. Met a lot of crazy people. Oliver North, Donald Trump, Ted Nugent.
That Miss Nugent.
Miss Nugent. Toby Nugent. Met them all.
Bunch of, a bunch of shooters. We got to, you know, rub heels with all the shooters. And
got
all
a lot of them coming on. Talk to us about competition shooting, things like that. It's going to be cool.
And, you know, what that one team Weatherby we got, there's a... there's a pro bull rider, a freaking professional fighter, a baseball player, and a lot of professional athletes besides a professional shooter on the team.
What the scary part is a bunch of those female shooters are hot.
Yeah.
And you know damn good and well if you piss them off, you're not getting through it alive.
No, they're going to get
500 yards down the road is just an easy shot for them.
Yeah,
I've met a lot of cool people and got a lot of invitations to do a lot of cool stuff. Hopefully we'll be able to go shoot some of these guns and the place there in Florida that has a sniper training, that'll be cool. So we'll be looking for some cool guests from the NRA convention. Got some of the Wounded Warriors. We're going to talk to some of them. They're going to be coming on. That's pretty cool.
It's wishes for warriors.
Yeah, wishes for warriors.
Yes, they're wounded, but, you know, it's Wishes for Warriors, the name of that foundation. And these guys, actually, they provide wishes that these guys want, you know, the guys, they actually went over and risked everything and lost a lot.
Yeah, we heard that some of the organizations to help the wounded soldiers don't want money from their raise from firearm shows.
Any of it, yeah.
The Wishes for Warriors, though, this guy we talked to said they just want any contributions they get to help these guys' dreams come true.
Yeah, it was a great show, man. So many damn people saw so many cool guns. It was incredible. But back to work, we got Bandit from Welcome to Myrtle Manor. I think he's got some movie he wants to come talk about, Lucky Smucks. I guess he's been a Lucky Smuck
being
cast on the Welcome to Myrtle Manor. Now some different movies and stuff. He's a unique character. So.
I feel like a Lucky Smuck.
Hey, he just sent us a picture wearing a Straight Hustling shirt, so that was cool. We got a few minutes before he comes on. Maybe we'll go out here and shoot some... firearms with some freedom munitions.
Oh, yeah. I think we need to hit them targets right now. Because you know what? We don't miss because these things, they don't miss fire. And they're really, really accurate ammunition.
What caliber are we going to use today? The 40s or the 45s?
I don't know. Maybe the 40s. But check them out. Click our link to go to their site. They got cool specials every day. Freedom munitions ammo. That's where we get our stuff. Shoot it up every time we come out here.
Ship it right to your house. It's a wonderful thing. You know, you wake up that morning, you got a box of ammo. What are you going to do? Blow something up.
So let's get the old bandit on the phone and see what's up.
Get your hustle on.
Hello, bandit here.
Hey, bandit, how you doing? This is Dick Darin with Straight Hustling.
Hey, man, how are you today?
Great. Hey, I got my buddy Money Mike and also Stu with me.
How's it going, bandit?
What's happening, man?
All righty. How about you guys? You guys having fun watching the show?
Oh, yeah. Ever since we've talked to Jelly Roll and got turned on to your show, we've been checking it out. It's crazy, man.
Yeah, he's really good. Yeah, man, I'm telling you. He's really talented. This kid, he's going to go somewhere real fast.
Oh, yeah. Hey, I want to thank y'all for inviting me down to the party down there at Myrtle Beach a couple weeks ago. Man, that was a blast. Get to meet everybody and had Jelly Roll performing, man. It was awesome.
That was really, really good. So you guys enjoyed that night, right?
Oh man, it was a blast, yeah.
Well, yeah, and your family enjoyed it, I hope, you know.
Yeah, it was really cool. Yeah, a lot of shots going down in there. You guys were partying hard.
Oh yeah, absolutely. You know, Brittany.
Oh yeah.
She's number one to get them, so. I love that girl, she's such a sweetheart.
Were you doing body shots off of her?
Not me. I don't drink.
No, you had your girlfriend there.
I mean, unless this girl has nice big breasts and I can choke it from there, no problem.
So what's going on down at the trailer park now? How's everything going now?
Well, everything seems to be fine. It's quiet. It's raining. A couple of people have just, you know, went to work. I seen Miss Peggy earlier. Tango's is very, really, really busy. They got people coming in and out. And every time I get outside, I got to stop and talk, you know, to everybody, of course, because they're inquisitive. They all want to know what's going on.
Yeah.
And you know what? We really can't tell anybody anything. We're not under oath, but we are in a contract where you're not supposed to say anything. And they keep asking us about this, that, and the other thing, but we really can't answer. You have to watch episode 8, 9, and 10, and that'll explain the whole story.
Is that going to explain?
And a lot of people are confused. They're really confused about the show.
Yeah. I'm wondering what happened to the swimming pool. That's what I want to know. I showed up and the swimming pool's gone.
Well, you see, that's, I can't say again. That's the question that keeps going around and around and around. And, well, you'll have to watch to find out.
We'll
You'd be watching. Surprised. Trust me, you're going to be surprised. Oh, very.
Give us a little history on how you got cast on the show. Like, so when did you actually move into the trailer park?
Okay. Well, where we got cast, actually, I had a recording studio. And I was living here for a few years before all this even happened. Like I said, that recording studio, I had the door open a little bit, and I was recording a band at that time. And these people just came walking in through the door with their cameras, and we waited till we were done, you know, recording. And I'm looking at the band, and I'm saying, is this your crew? And the band's looking at me and says, no. And then the guy, Matt Sprouse, did say to me, would you like to be on TV? We'd never seen a recording studio in a mobile home park before. So I said, on TV, what is this, like a commercial? He goes, no, we're doing a reality show. Would you like to be on it? I said, yeah, sure, no problem. Not even asking about the pay, you know what I'm saying? Like, stupid me. No, I mean, they should do it for free. But they do compensate you very little, though. It's not like a Honey Boo Boo or the Jersey Sisters or whatever you want to call them, Jersey, whatever they call them out there. Yeah, the Jersey Girls or Housewives and all those kind of things. Now, no, we're not like that. Not even in their category. But I'm very surprised that we get over 1.1 million in views almost every week. I'm very shocked on that one.
Yeah, man.
Although we are, now we're worldwide. We weren't before, but now we're worldwide, which is pretty good, but it doesn't benefit us. It benefits most, advertising and the commercials, and that's what makes, the TV, you know? That's what runs everybody, is the commercials. You know, if you got a paid spot, $30,000 for, you know, 3 seconds. And that's a different story. You know, you got $150,000 you got to pay for a Super Bowl or something. That's where they make their money. You know, we don't make money like that. We don't get royalties. We're just a reality show.
Right.
We do a very first in the original from South Carolina this long as an original reality show.
And hopefully, you know, you guys got season 4 coming, so I was going to do your negotiation for the contract.
Yeah, I've never heard about the season. I never heard about season 4 coming at all. I'm actually still looking for another job. The jingles are getting very slow, and the modeling now is slowing down really immensely, especially for my age.
It's bikini weather, man. Your modeling should be picking up.
You got to get your Speedo back out and get a Brazilian.
I'm thinking about making a line of bikinis for these girls and then autograph them while it's on them. So,
yeah,
hey, you know.
Right.
But that's besides the point. I'm just, you know, I'm like a regular person. We look all, actually, Amanda just got another job. God bless her. And she's doing good. This is the second or third day, and wow, it's like fantastic. I mean, somebody got a job. At least we can pay our rent and we don't get evicted. I mean, if it's season 4, you're gonna find out that if there is a season 4, well, it's gonna be changed. It's not gonna be like the way it is. Probably going to be more funnier and more of involved in your life instead of just like bits and pieces here and there so you can guess. It's more like going to be involved. This is what I'm speculating. If there is a season 4, there is. I have no idea. We'll never know until the last minute. When they start popping their cameras in our faces, then there's season 4. That's how we know.
So you're going to let me negotiate your contract for season 4?
So if you want to. Yeah. I got 6 more months in my contract, so... I mean, I can sell my car, but I can't cut my hair. I can't change my style, not for another 6 months, because that's how I was and that's how it would have to be.
So what's the car you got? The Firebird you got in the driveway?
Yeah, the Firebird. I'm putting that up for sale. It's already got up, actually it's on auction bidding. And it's got the 2700, and I'm like, oh, you're kidding me, 2700. Okay, well, whatever.
Does the radar detector come with it?
Yeah, radar detector. Yeah, everything comes with it, including the switches and everything. I had NAS in that thing at one time when I had a six-cylinder in it, but I blew to the engine because of it, and I put a Corvette engine in it. Ever since then, I've never had a problem. I love this thing, except for no air conditioning. You can't put it in there because it's a 350 big block.
Yeah.
There's no way you can fit it in. You got to cut the frame. I'm like, no way am I cutting the frame. That's it. Never had an accident in this thing. It's, you know, need to be painted, that's for sure. And I would hope a TLC would be doing it one day, but hey, man, you know, that's life.
So yeah. when your 6 months is up, are you going to donate your hair?
Yeah, 6 months. I got to keep growing it. I'm not going to cut my hair anyway. I'm not changing my style.
Well, you can't anyway, right? I mean, I thought you was going to since they said you could.
Let me tell you guys, when I say we go back to the 70s, relive the 70s, I love the 70s and the 80s. That is my, my sexual fantasy back then.
How did you get the nickname Bandit? What's the story on that?
Is that
your real name?
Back in school, back in school, I had a 73 Dodge Challenger, but I always loved Firebirds, and they always loved the Camaros, the 1965s and everything. So I used to redo them all the time. And then when this movie comes out, Smokey and the Bandit, I had a Trans Am at that time. And they just called me Bandit ever since, because I had a license plate specially made saying Bandit. I was copying Smokey and the Bandit.
Oh, okay.
It just stuck with me, and then in the front, and I also had the, we call it Superman on it, and that both of them names have stuck with me since high school.
Oh, wow. That's cool.
Yeah, but, you know, Chelsea, I told everybody my nickname was Bandit. Chelsea kept, the whole first year, the whole first season, she called me Band-Aid instead of Bandit. I'm like, Band-Aid? And she's like, look at me. She laughs her ass off. This is way before they got married and everything, both Jared and Chelsea. But she was such a sweetheart. She's a great mom these days. I'll tell you, she has changed dramatically. She's like from a teenage kid to a perfect mother.
Yeah.
Between her and Jared, they are great parents. I never seen them happier in my life either. I'm like, wow.
That's awesome.
I'm just waiting for the next kid to pop up. I know Jared. I know how he is. He can't keep this thing in his pants there, Bubba. Every chance they can get. So, I mean, hey, well, I would too, you know?
Well, I think Roy's been trying to take him up on that, ain't he?
Roy is a different story. I mean, what would you like to know about Roy that I really cannot, you know, specify specifically about him, because Roy is Roy.
How are his
he changes his mind like everybody changes their underwear and socks.
How are his Brazilian waxes?
Actually, yes. That waxing that I did in that one season, oh, my God. I'll tell you, he didn't do such a good job. I really have a woman. That would have been better, first of all. Second of all, when he put the wax on me, you put powder on that specific spot so you don't get your hair, you know, pulled off and everything. Well, actually, this where the spot was so close to my cañones, the wax dripped onto it, and when it dried and he pulled it holding off, he actually ripped the hair right off of my ball. And I'll tell you, when you hear that scream, that is a real scream coming out of there.
I
bled for 3 days. I was bleeding. When I walked out that door, I seen Becky. I'm like, oh, my God. And I'm bleeding. My balls are bleeding. She's over there. What are you doing in the salon? I'm like, I'm trying to put flame through her, and I'm holding my breath as much as I can not to just say a word. And I just walked out with and blood dripping down my leg. I'm like, you got to be kidding me. Neosporin for 3 days.
Did you have to wear a man
paw? Unbelievable. I'll never do it again. Don't even ask. Nope, I won't.
Did you have to wear a man paw after that?
I never wore anything after that. I went commando.
Man, that's a rough one. Did you sell the Brazilian wax tape on eBay?
If I would have took it out of the garbage, I probably would have.
Go ahead and get the bidding started on that. See what you can throw it in with the car.
I need it.
Yeah, but with all that blood on there, I don't think they would want it.
Biohead.
And part of the skin.
So, what part of the, you said you had a band going. What did you, play an instrument or something?
Yeah, actually, I play guitar, I play bass, I play drums and keyboards, and I do a little bit of singing here and there. That's on the side. But nice. my main part of this is I'm actually an electrician.
Oh, okay.
And I actually, that's how I injured myself and got disabled. I fell 14 feet and a pallet came down and just struck me in the shoulder, cracked my shoulder right in half. I'm surprised I can even use it, my arm now as it is, but I still can't raise it above my head. I still can't lift anything more than a pound and a half with that right hand. It's just totally, it's no longer good.
Yeah.
So what I do normally can do, and I practice so much, I can do my keyboards again, and I can strum at a certain amount, and then after like two or three songs, I have to stop.
Oh, okay.
Because the pain gets excruciating, and my muscle starts tightening up, and I just can't use my right arm.
I heard Brock was starting a little guitar playing. Did you get many lessons on that?
Yeah, actually, this Thursday, you'll see it on TV. I did teach him a little bit more than what, you know, he's been doing. And he's doing pretty well right now. But on TV, yeah, we're going to have a concert up on stage. So don't miss it this Thursday night at 10 o'clock now. Okay? It's going to be the Bandit and the Double Wise will be starring in this concert Roxy is throwing to Myrtle Manor.
Uh-oh, we got the scoop right here. Mm-hmm. That's cool.
Okay.
So what about you? Got any commercials or any kind of movies or anything going from
well,
the
I am,
show?
I'm actually working. We're working on right now. I'm producing along with Jason Loveland, and we're doing. If you want to look it on the IMBD, you can also look at it. Lucky Schmucks is the name of the movie, and we're going to be producing and starring in it. Hopefully, we're going to get Seth Rogen along with us. Also with Tommy Chong appearing, the Tommy Chong, he'll be popping in and out. But it's going to be a funny movie. It's going to be, I do believe, shot in Fayetteville, North Carolina, and part of it will be here in South Carolina, Myrtle Beach.
Okay, well, let me know when that starts up, man. We'll come down there and take some pictures
well,
of you on the set.
Well, just keep checking on my Facebook, and I have all my results up there, and, you know, it's coming soon. We've got the script already done. What we're doing is just, you know, rehearsing all the parts. We're trying to get all these other people together. And then we're going to start shooting. Hopefully, if we don't have season four, if I have season four, then that may, you know, have a controversy against one another. And I don't know if we're going to be able to do that with the contract.
Right.
So, apparently what I could do is just send everything into TLC and into my company itself. So this way we can get, corresponding with what's going on here, lawyer to lawyer, to make sure I'm doing the right thing at the right time. I don't want to get messed up with somebody and have to say, okay, oh, you're going to jail because you're breaching your contract. I'm like, uh-oh, I don't want to be doing that. So I'm playing it safe.
Yeah, yeah, right.
I think you just lose a lot of money. You won't go to jail, Bandit. The band knows how to run from the law.
With all the popularity, man, I can't see them not giving y'all a season four. I was there in the trailer park. I seen all the nonstop traffic.
Well, it depends now on the viewers also. I mean, if somebody's out there and they really don't like, the way we're portraying Myrtle Beach as, I don't know, a trash town, which we're not. We are family here. Everybody helps one another. Everybody has something to say. If they have something on their mind, doesn't mean that they're mad at each other. They have something on their mind. So maybe somebody carries away a little bit too far because they're drinking, but those are kids.
Yeah.
We're talking about, you know, adults here. We're all adults, no matter if we're drinking, not drinking, if we're kids, if we're not kids. We're all family. We all stick together as a family.
Yeah. And, you know, it's a comedy, too. You know, it's a reality comedy. That's made to be fun. You guys have a good time.
Well, yeah, it's reality. This is what we do. I mean, when there's no cameras here, you gotta be here because there's sometimes really dramatic, or it could be really extremely funny where you wish somebody was there, you know, recording it at the same time.
What's the craziest thing you've seen happen in the trailer park on all the years you've been living there? Do you think this really?
And all the oh my god, in all the years I've ever seen something crazy when. Actually, Miss Peggy took her clothes off in the pool while she was in the pool. Yeah, absolutely. That was my craziest moment. Everything else is follows. But that I wouldn't want to see no more. Trust me, that no way, no. I'm looking if I can get it up after that.
Oh man, it scarred you for life, huh?
Not the life. I got over it because she actually seen me in a deleted scene that we did, and I was in an art class, and I just took my robe right down, and she was like, oh, my God.
Oh, shit.
So you got to look that up on YouTube one day, or Google it up, Bandit's deleted scene. Okay. You're going to love that one.
Yeah, I wanted to check that out, man. We got a little thing we do called the hustling round. We just ask you some questions, and you just say the first thing that pops in your mind. You mind doing that?
All right, sure. Yeah.
All right, so if Bandit is elected president tomorrow, what's the first thing that you would do?
Man, if I was elected president tomorrow, the first thing I would do is make all these girls topless, first of all. Definitely, without a doubt. That would be my first priority on my list.
I don't know topless about all women. Of them.
Yeah, really. Some of them need to keep their top on.
We have to select few. We'll let you interview all of them. You can decide who gets to keep it on and off.
Exactly. You got it.
We're going to make yoga pants mandatory?
I don't think I should. I think everybody should wear whatever they want to wear.
What about your favorite vacation spot?
Ah, my favorite vacation spot would definitely be Myrtle Manor, right here at Patrick's Mobile Home Park.
All right.
This is where all the excitement and all the fun is.
Yeah, right.
You leave this place, it's boring. Trust me.
All right, on the show Myrtle Manor, who's the biggest flirt?
I would say the biggest flirt on Myrtle Manor definitely would be Brock, without a doubt. I mean, he has eyes and hands and fingers that actually they're Russian and Roman. They're Roman hands and Russian fingers is what I call him. And his eyes is always focused on one spot, those mountains that the women wear every day called breasts.
Well, hell, if he gets you to be elected president, he'd be checking them out all the time.
I wouldn't want Brock to be president. Definitely not, because there would be no work done in this world. Oh, yeah, there would be on women only.
All right. What about your favorite drink?
My favorite drink would be a tequila sunrise, if I did drink. Okay. Well, I used to drink. That was my favorite.
What's your favorite just drink that you drink normally, maybe non-alcoholic?
Non-alcoholic drink would be a root beer.
All right. Okay, you're stranded on an island with one castmate from Myrtle Manor. Who do you pick?
Now if I was on a deserted island, the first cast, that's a tricky question. That's a very tricky question because actually there were two of them that I would like to have with me. And that would be Jessica and Brittany, both one on one side, one on the other.
All right.
A bandit sandwich.
Your favorite Kardashian?
I would have to mention. I would have to say Kim. Kim, sure. She's got the technique. She got the suave. She's got the personality. The girl that really kicks. And that's what I like in a woman. A girl that really kicks. Look out, Kim, baby. She's good.
Look out, Kanye. Bandit's coming for your woman.
Yeah, I know, right? No, I would never do that to him.
Pick any person in the world that you would like to co-star in a movie picture with.
I definitely would hang with Bruce Willis.
All right, definitely. Cool. Yeah, all right. You can do a new Die Hard with Bandit. Die Hard 10.
Yeah, Bandit and Bruce. That would be good. Bandit and Bruno. That would be even better. You ever hear his band, Bruno? Excellent. Excellent band. He plays down here at Myrtle Beach pretty much.
Well, we'll check him out next time we come back.
Yeah, you gotta check him out once in a while. He's really good. He is definitely good. He's a blues player, and he's a great singer. Nice. He still is. After all these years, unbelievable.
On the show Myrtle Manor, who's the person that makes you laugh the most?
I would say the person who makes me laugh the most would be Marvin, because he's so dumbfounded.
Is that the security guard? All right.
Marvin, he doesn't mean that.
Yeah. Marvin's coming on the show too, Bandit.
He knows what I'm talking about.
Okay. On Welcome to Myrtle Manor, if that show was like the Survivor TV show and you had to vote one person off, who's got to go?
Man. I'll tell you one thing right now. One would have to definitely go. I would say Brock, because he's taking all of my women away from me.
Let's get him out of there. All right. Yeah,
no more competition. That's what I'm talking about.
All right. On all the
No more competition.
On all the cast members, who's the most likely to get arrested in the future?
Ah, and the whole, now that's another good question. I would say, if they're really careful, if they're not careful, well, it's either Jessica or Brittany.
We need to get you on an island with him to protect him.
Yeah.
I will definitely, I would come down there and help him out, without a doubt. I mean, they would definitely call me if they couldn't really drive. They would call somebody who's really close. I know them very well, and they don't drink and drive the way everybody suspects they do. They don't. They sit here at the park, they drink, they have fun, and they go home. And when they're out and we're partying, like for a view, viewing, and we just have very little in the beginning. And then towards the end, when we watch it, you're all sobered up by then. And then you go home, because it's an after party at home. Then you go have a new drink at home, and you have fun.
Oh, yeah.
This is what we do. We be respectable now. We got to make sure that everything is A-okay. We're not going to be, you know, bad with the law at all down here.
Yeah, right. I'm sure they have a keen eye on you down there, don't they?
Yeah, they frown on that. They'll stop you for every 5 seconds then, and you know, give you a breathalyzer just for the hell of it. So you don't want to be dealing with that whatsoever. I don't, that's for sure.
Yeah, right. All right, here's a Tangles question for you. Just pick one, Gina or Roy. No sense to it. Just pick Gina or Roy.
Well, I would pick Gina because Gina's more more friendly. She's more, I would say, my type than Roy would be.
Sounds like Roy's an asshole.
Well, he actually said something I really didn't want him to say, that, you know, women out there know that now I got a huge schlong. Everybody knows that now. Thank you, Roy. Wanted to be the surprise for these women, but now they're all, you know, like, oh, no, I'm not touching. He's too big. No way. Small guy, big. No. You know, this boy is Roy. That's the way he sees things. He said it.
Roy hooked you up, man. How are you not going to pick Roy? He's got you out there for everybody. That's your goal. That's your boy.
So yeah, yeah, true in a way, but in a way, like, you know, keep it to yourself a little bit.
Okay, here's one. Last question we got is your favorite Nashville podcast.
Ah, that's Straight Hustling.
All right, man. Man, we wish you all the best. I want to thank you for coming on, man. It was really cool and really enjoyed meeting you, man. And I got your picture wearing our shirt. That is super cool. And, man, I wish you the best. And if you get that movie going, let us know. We'll come down there and take some pictures of you and Tommy Chong. That'd be pretty cool.
Okay, definitely. That would be cool, too. Yeah, definitely, because I would love to have that. That's going to be no doubt anyway. That's going to be background scenes of that movie being made, because my son's going to also be the producer or co-producer. So he's going to be director also. He's going to be doing the background shots, is what you saw, behind scenes type of thing. Yeah. So you'll see a lot of that going up on the internet soon also. But yeah, I'm definitely going to be wearing this shirt in that movie. Plus, you're going to see a lot of it on with my fans.
Yeah,
on
the page. Can't wait, so man.
The name will be advertised quite a bit.
We really appreciate that, Bandit, because, you know, we're a big fan of your
show.
Hey,
man, you guys are cool. So what can I tell you? You know, you guys are cool with me. I'm cool with you. I'm from New York. How you doing? You know what I mean? How you doing? I'm from New York. Okay.
Well, we're going to come down there again to interview you. We're going to come down there, and we'll hopefully season 4 we'll get with you and see all the exciting stuff. And, man, you guys got a lot of fans. Great show, man. Look forward to seeing you. We'll keep watching Thursday night, 10 o'clock. We'll check
TLC,
you out.
TLC.
Yeah, don't forget now, every Thursday night at 10 o'clock, only on TLC, will you see. Welcome to Myrtle Manor. This is going to be great. Episode 8, 9, and 10. You guys are going to love it. Trust me. It's going to be a mind twister.
All right.
It's going to be a cliffhanger.
We're looking forward to it.
But you're going to love it.
We're going to check it out, man. I want to thank you for coming on our show, and I'll let you know when we put this out there, man. And thanks for wearing our shirt.
Hey, anytime, my man. You got my number. We'll talk soon.
All right. Thank you, Bandit.
All right. Bye.
All right. Bye-bye.
All right. That's the show with Bandit from Myrtle Manor. We'll be looking for him on season 4. We got to check out the next few episodes to see what happens. Sounds like there's some crazy stuff going on.
Yeah. Yeah, if all the guests from that show are like him, this is going to be a wild ride, I'm telling you.
Yeah.
But this is the second guest we've had, and we've got, what, one more coming, and then
today. We've got a bunch of them coming, yeah.
Well, one today, and then, you know, getting a bunch more in the future.
So, Thursday night, 10 o'clock Eastern. Check it out. See what's going on. Somebody TLC. Got some secretive stuff. I know the pool's gone. I didn't see it when I was there. They won't tell me what happened to it.
But it's on TLC for you listeners out there. The show comes on every Thursday night, 10 o'clock, TLC. Central time, though.
That's Eastern.
No, it's Eastern time.
Eastern time, 10 o'clock?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. So that'd be 9 Central.
Plus. Don't you have that shit recorded?
Yeah, but you know, that's my DVR. You know, it broke yesterday.
You got the DVR on that 12-inch black and white TV?
I got that DVR.
DVR.
I got a DVR.
All right. Well, that was a cool show. We got a lot of cool people coming up still to come. I don't know who's doing our website shit.
No, but, you know, if you ain't hustling, you ain't doing nothing right.
You got to get the website information. Check out our website. And also, be sure to leave comments. We got a couple comments. That was cool. A lot of people liking our show, leaving the comments on the site. Thank you, everybody. Thank you for all the comments on iTunes.
And everybody ordering them T-shirts. They're flying off the shelves, man. You know, all these stars are wearing them. You can get yours, too, right at straighthustling.com, no doubt.
Yep, we're getting ready to post our picture of a Bandit wearing the T-shirt. Yeah, that's cool.
Bandit, Bob. I mean, how many more people need to wear this shirt before you realize that it's caught on, people?
Stu, give them the website information so they know where to go.
Hey, I'll be sure to check us out at www.str8hustling.com.
Damn, I thought you wrote it on the wall. You're looking at the wall up there.
Oh, my God. Damn, is somebody crawling in the window that ain't there?
All right, we're going to have to cut these two off. You ain't hustling. You ain't living.
Oh, shit.
Go to our website. Check out our shows. We got a lot of cool stuff coming. We're out of here.
Peace.
Bandit for life.
I'm the dopest of dopest niggas. I'm blowing dope out my swisher. Got coke I'm trying to distribute. You need me, I can't assist you. These bitches, I never mind them. They bad enough, then I find them. I'm taking them and I'm buying them. Anything that's designed. I'm the shrewdest of individuals. Swagger is at its pinnacle. Getting money is typical. Go and flip me a brick or two. Red bottoms for tennis shoes. Louis loafers and business suits. YSL and Prada and Salvatore Ferragamo. I'm a dope nigga riding in my dope whip. Got your main bitch hooked off the first sniff. You a lame nigga stunting in your rental car. I'm the same nigga, bitch, you know I've been a star. Stunting on these niggas, flipping bricks. Every other day, you know I'm switching licks. I'm that fish scale, that uncut hair on the purest of the pure. While you other niggas stepped on.
I'm a dope nigga riding in a dope car. Got a dope bitch, no panties, no bra. I'm a dope boy, just made 100 large. I'm so motherfucking round, bitch, I'm about to catch a dope charge. Dope charge,
bitch, I'm about to catch a
dope charge. Dope charge,
bitch, I'm about to catch a
dope charge. Dope charge,
bitch, I'm about to catch a
dope charge. Dope charge,
bitch, I'm about to catch
a. I'm a dope nigga riding in a dope car. Got a dope bitch, no panties, no bra. I'm a dope boy, just made 100 large. I'm so motherfucking round, bitch, I'm about to catch a dope charge. Dope charge,
bitch, I'm about to catch a
dope charge. Dope charge,
bitch, I'm about to catch a
dope charge. Dope charge,
bitch, I'm about to catch a
dope charge. Dope charge,
bitch, I'm about to catch a